Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to remove the background of your footage without using green screen in After Effects. Before we begin, don't forget to click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so you will be notified for our future tutorials. And now, let's get started. Okay, so first let's refresh our memory on the green screen workflow. In theory, it's really simple. All you need is a shot of your subject in front of a green screen, and then in After Effects, you want to get Keylight and then grab the green color or blue if you use blue screen. And then of course, we want to play around with the settings a little bit to get a cleaner key. And there we go, we have removed the green background from the plate. So then what if you don't have any access to green or blue screen? Well, one of the solutions is to substitute the green and blue color with another color information. Like for example, luminance or brightness. So what you want to do is to shoot your subject in front of a very bright background. Like here, I am shooting myself standing behind this bright sky. And then we want to use luminance keying method to get rid of the bright area, which in After Effects, we can achieve that with extract. Now let's push the white point a little bit and we can see how quickly the sky got removed because of how bright it is. Next, we are going to fix the leftover pixels that we have on the edges. So let's push our key a little bit more here. And now we are faced with our first problem. Because we use brightness as the information that we want to remove, we can see that some area of our shot being eroded along with the sky. This is because these areas here are the highlight of my face. And the highlights is almost as bright, if not the same brightness as the sky. So it gets eaten away by the key as well. So to work around that, what we can do is to first erode as much of the brightness that we can, and that would leave us with a lot of alpha holes in our shot. So we want to fill those holes by creating another key. So let's duplicate our layer, and in this duplicate, we want to pull back the key until we get some of the area that we lost back. And then we want to create a mask, and we want to mask the areas that fill the holes of our original key. And we want to do this a couple more times until all of our subjects are filled in. Sometimes extract still couldn't retain some details, no matter how meticulous our key is. So at that point, you just have to do a manual frame-by-frame masking. Okay, so everything looks great. Now we want to smooth out the edges of your luminance key, like on the hair here. So let's pre-comp our layers, and then add refine soft matte, and now our matte edges here is softer, especially around the hair. And then after that, we want to add the background image of our shot. So here I have this footage of a cloudy sky being put below everything, and then on top of that, I have added this flying bird elements from our ActionVFX flying birds collection. Now we want to smooth out the details of my hair a little bit more. So let's bring our original footage again, put it just below our key pre-comp, and then we want to change the blend mode to multiply. And there we go. We have removed the background and the edge of our key looks pretty good. Now I know I didn't go step by step on this one, so if you want to know how exactly I did this key, you can check out the project file in the description below. Also, if you somehow get a cloudless blue sky as your background, it's even better because you can just treat the blue sky as your blue screen. And that was the luminance keying method. It's very simple, just you, your camera, and the sky. However, the problem with this method is you have to shoot outdoor, which means that your lighting options on set is very limited. So if luminance keying is not an option, that means we have to go back to the basic, which is rotoscoping or frame-by-frame masking. Now, I know frame-by-frame masking, that sounds a bit scary, but in After Effects, there is actually a tool to help ease out this process called Rotobrush. Rotobrush is basically a semi-automatic rotoscoping tool in After Effects. To use Rotobrush, all you have to do is click the Rotobrush button in the toolbar, and then on your shot, you want to smear the brush across the area that we want to keep, like our guy here. Once you start smearing, After Effects is going to guess your selection based on the color and contrast of that area that you select. So you want to keep smearing until we cover our guy entirely. And then sometimes, we have the Rotobrush taking some parts of the background, so to remove that, hold Alt and then exclude that area. Now that we have our Rotobrush, we can look at the different display settings here to check the accuracy of our selection. And then here on the effects panel, we have the settings for our Rotobrush. For example, we want to reduce the contrast here so we have a smoother edge on our selection. Now, let's get a more detailed selection of the hair. So, let's select the Refine Edge tool here, and then we want to smear across our hair edges. And there we go, we can see that After Effects has figured out the details of our hair. And then, we want to start our rotoscoping. So go one frame forward, and then here we see that the rotobrush shape is following our subject. And then here we want to check the details of our rotobrush in this frame. If there is any issue, we have to fix it. And then we want to go to another frame, and if there's any issue, fix that again. And we want to do this for the entire duration. Once we are done rotoscoping the entire duration, we want to click freeze, and that way After Effects will save our selection so we don't have to worry about accidentally changing our roto. Now that we have our roto, let's check our composition. And there we go. One tip I want to give about rotobrushing is that since rotobrush works by guessing the color contrast of your shot, you want to make sure that your subject stands out from the background, kind of like the shot that we have here. The depth of field really helps separate our character from the blurry background, which in turn gives rotobrush easier time on guessing the edges. And that was the tutorials on ways to remove background without green screen. Now, none of the methods that I just showed you are meant to be replacement of the green screen techniques. These are just alternative options. Once you are done removing the background from your shot, you're probably going to need some VFX elements to fill in your composition, just like the birds elements that I used in one of my shots, which you can get at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high-quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. And see you next time. Bye-bye.